end of the year, it's easy to say that you're going to leave those 12 months behind, along with all the experiences you had during that time. But it's not so simple to actually do that. It's also not so easy to leave your past emotional baggage from the year behind. In fact, that's why most of us carry that emotional baggage with us from year to year to year to year, allowing it to weigh us down and keep us mired in old memories, thoughts, emotions, and beliefs. The brain actually has a tendency to dwell on the negative. We don't focus on the positive memories and emotions as often. I don't know why it is, but that's just how the brain is wired for the negative. So we bring fewer positive memories and emotions into the future. And instead, we tote an ever larger, ever heavier suitcase of negative ones with us into our future. And that's why there's the adage, wherever you go, there you are, because, you know, a lot of people think they're going to move to a new city or change a job or change relationships and that things will be different. But if you're carrying your emotional baggage with you into those new situations, nothing changes. You haven't changed. Now, at the end of this year, there's a spiritual tradition or ceremony that a lot of people like to do in order to try to release that emotional baggage and not bring it into the new year. These are the kind of things that I talk about a lot in my Inspired Creator community, where we're doing personal and spiritual growth. So talking about how to actually release this old emotional baggage is one of the topics we cover a lot. And when it came to the new year, what I talked to them about was the religious ritual I have. And it's sometimes called the burning bowl ceremony. I don't use a bowl. I usually use the fireplace. But the idea is this, is that you get a piece of paper and you make a list of all the things you don't want to bring with you into the new year. This could be a health issue or a relationship or a job or an emotion like anger or sadness. It could be lack consciousness, anything like that you just don't want to bring into the new year. And so you write it on a piece of paper and then you put it in a bowl and you burn it, or you put it in the fireplace and burn it, or you put it in the sink and burn it. But it's this intentional, spiritual, energetic release, a symbolic release of what you don't want anymore. Now, I believe that Source or God or Creator responds to that type of intention. And that's what this really is. It's the intention to release, to leave the past in the past, especially the emotional baggage part of it. But because we've focused on those items on the list for weeks, months, years, and we did so with a lot of emotion, it sometimes takes more than one action related to that intention to feel or see a difference, for us to change, to see our circumstances change. So we often need to actively, consciously, intentionally commit to releasing that old baggage. So that means consistently doing something different. So what's the different thing that you have to do? Specifically, you have to stop focusing on the past and feeling the emotions that correspond with those events and experiences from the past. That's how you kind of disconnect from them. But it's challenging to leave that emotional baggage at the curb. It really is. I know this. I have worked at this many, many years. There's still some things I'm having trouble dropping at the curb. And the reason is because you and I, we've trained our brains to think about past events and experiences. And those thoughts that we're thinking about the past trigger emotions in our body. So the way to leave the baggage at the curb, the emotional baggage at the curb, is to change what we think about, to retrain our mind, whether that's our conscious mind or usually it's our subconscious mind, to focus on the positive aspects of the past, the present moment, or the future you desire. So we're training our brain again to focus on the positive aspects of the past, on the present moment, and the future that you desire. Now, each time you move your thoughts from the past to the present or to the future, you demonstrate your commitment to intentionally leaving that baggage behind. So you're basically making the setting that intention over and over again. And eventually, because you're retraining your mind, you won't think about the experience or feel the emotion unless you choose to do so. Because what you're doing is you're choosing your thoughts, right? You're not allowing your subconscious mind to bring up the thoughts and emotions that you don't really want to be thinking about, that old emotional baggage. You're choosing new thoughts instead. And that's when you, when you're making those kind of choices, that's when things start to change for you and in your life, and you change. That's when you leave something from your suitcase, maybe more than one thing, in a trash can or in a bag at the curb for the garbage truck to pick up. Now, I know, as I said, that it's, you know, that I've experienced it myself, that it is difficult to drop the emotional baggage, but it can be done. But because it's hard, that's why so many people take those suitcases filled with their memories and emotions with them wherever they go. But that's not what we want to do. That's not what I'm challenging you to do today. So I would like to challenge you to try some ways to empty your emotional baggage, so the load gets lighter and the bags get smaller, and you can experience the transformation you want, the change. You can keep those large suitcases, by the way, and you can fill them with positive memories and emotions from your life. And that bag is never going to be too heavy for you to carry. It's going to be light as a feather. So what are some things you can do to release the emotional baggage? So the first one is kind of the classic: hire a therapist. Therapists are trained to help you look at your past, understand it, and release it so that you can make changes in the present and in the future. The other thing, so that's number one, is hire a therapist. Number two is to find support groups or group counseling programs. So there are support groups like for survivors of physical abuse, or you know, people who have a spouse who's an alcoholic, things like that. So you can find a support group like that, or you can get into a group counseling program. Support groups very often have somebody who is a social worker or a therapist or someone who's leading the program. And then, but there's also group counseling, which will have some sort of a counselor, like a therapist who's leading the group. And that could be a grief group. It could be an anger group. It could be a men's group, a women's group. But the fact is that you get together with other people, and that's super helpful to support you in talking about figuring out how to deal with, how to change this emotional baggage that you're carrying around. Another thing you can do that's super helpful is to try hypnosis. Hypnosis is an awesome way for you to retrain your subconscious mind, or program your subconscious mind. And you can do self-hypnosis. There are tapes out there, and you know, that will teach you how to do self-hypnosis. There are also, you can also hire a hypnotherapist to do hypnosis with you. And so if you're struggling to let go of past experiences, to stop thinking about them and feeling the emotions and getting triggered, a hypnotherapist can be an amazing help. The fourth thing, so we had hire a therapist, find a support group or group counseling program, and try hypnosis. And the fourth one is to visualize yourself living without that emotional baggage. So this is another way to reprogram your mind or your subconscious mind. And that's to actually see yourself living the kind of life you would live and being the kind of person you would be if you didn't have the emotional baggage. So you just spend time every day, two or three times a day, for just a little while, seeing that, seeing yourself like in a movie, what that would be like to not have the emotional baggage. How would you be acting? How would you be living? Then you actually put yourself into that scene, and you feel, and you see, you feel, you smell, you use all your senses to experience what that life would be like and what you would be like, what it would feel like to be you in that situation. And then you can also see the future, you know, what it would be like in a few months to be living, if you lived that way for 3 months, what would your life be like and what would you be like? So that's visualization. That can also be done in self-hypnosis or with a hypnotherapist, and super effective. The last thing is to act as if, number five, is to act as if you're a person with no emotional baggage. So just, again, imagine how you would show up if you didn't have that emotional baggage. How would you react in relationships? How would you be at work? What would your life look like? But mostly it's, how would you be? How would you think? How would you feel? How would you behave? What would you believe? and then just decide to be that person today. Okay. It sounds harder than it is. You actually, you know, it's just making a decision that you aren't, you know, you're a person whose emotional baggage doesn't affect you anymore, and then acting in a way that corresponds with that. So as I was writing this blog post, I was writing the blog post that goes with this video, and I started thinking about a song by Jackson Brown that I absolutely adore. It's called The Late Show. And I want to read you just a little bit of the lyrics. They're at the very end of the song, and they apply to what we're talking about to hear today about releasing your emotional baggage. And the words of the song say, look, it's like you're standing in the window of a house nobody lives in, and I'm sitting in a car across the way. Let's just say it's an early model Chevrolet. And let's just say it's a warm and windy day. You go and pack your sorrow. The trash man comes tomorrow. Leave it at the curb. We'll just roll away. Try visualizing that every day. Imagine that you pack up your negative thoughts and experiences and emotions from the last year and years past and put them in suitcases or big black garbage bags, and you put them by the curb and you get in the car and you drive away unencumbered by all of that. That visualization alone will help you do exactly that. I have seen people do similar visualizations, like around money, you know, your issues around money and thinking of who gave them to you and giving them back. Same idea. Just pack it all up, leave it by the curb, and drive away. Let me know how this works for you. Hey, I'm really curious to know if you have other ways of leaving your emotional baggage behind, or if you're struggling with leaving your emotional baggage behind. What is it that you dream of for the new year in terms of that? How do you want to show up without your emotional baggage? So leave me a comment on this video, or on the blog. If you're reading the blog, leave it on the blog. I'd love to hear. And please share this video or the blog post with some friends who might find this useful. So I'm Nina Amir. I'm the Inspiration to Creation Coach. I'm a certified high performance coach and author coach. I love helping people get from where they are to where they want to go without letting anything get in the way. And mostly what's in the way is you, which means what's going on up here and how that's affecting how you show up every day. So that's my passion. I bring to my work, the personal growth work, the certified high performance coaching, and even with my writers, I bring to that ancient wisdom, metaphysics, spirituality. And so if that is of interest to you, you might really enjoy my Inspired Creator community, where I offer both personal and spiritual growth with that kind of mystical flair. So you can find out about the Inspired Creator community above. There is a link, and I would love for you to join. If you're interested just in personal growth or personal development, and you have been searching for a certified high performance coach, I would love to work with you, or at least to meet you and see whether we're a good fit to work together. And if that's of interest to you, click on the other link above, which is for a free certified high performance coaching breakthrough strategy session. And that's 90 minutes of my time I give to you for free. And we decide whether or not we're a good fit and whether high performance coaching is what you want. So you can apply for that above. There's a link to apply for that session. So that's it for today. I would love again to hear how you're dealing with your emotional baggage, how you're leaving it by the curb. So leave me a comment. And until I talk to you next time, go out there and achieve more inspired results.